I have been in research all my life and was working at the Sloan Kettering Institute for Cancer Research in New York when the first cases of AIDS occurred, and some physicians who were friends of mine brought them to my and others' attention. I took a special interest in this disease because of its possible viral causation. You know, the cause of it was likely to be a virus from the beginning, and I had done research on substances that suppress viruses and so forth. It started as a scientific interest, and then I got to meet people with AIDS and to become familiar with their problems, and not only the medical problems, but the social problems, and became convinced that the social problems were as serious potentially as the medical problems for society at large, and not only for the people who have AIDS. The American Foundation for AIDS Research was created to support scientific, medical, and social sciences research on AIDS. It was also created to serve as a source of information to the public and to policymakers on AIDS. Information that is hopefully, and I know it is, most of the time more accurate and more up-to-date than they can get from other sources. The way we conduct our operations, we really can accelerate the pace at which research makes progress. And we also have been, I think, useful in informing the public and fostering the right attitudes, you know, supporting attitudes of compassion and of rationality as opposed to emotionalism and fear. I have given up the lab over the last 2 years because this, I think, is something that many other people can do. We have many very good scientists in this country. In my situation, at my stage in life, I think I'm more useful as a spokesperson and also as a writer. I write a lot, I publish, I speak a lot, and I try to translate what I know to others, to lay people in simple language to make them understand. I try to speak also to people who in society make decisions for others, people in government and in positions of importance. The amount of ignorance is terrible, and not only about AIDS, you know, because there are certain things in order to understand AIDS properly, one has to understand certain very basic things in biology, in health, that many people don't understand at all, and this is why they're so confused. And from the press, they are informed, they receive news, but it's always a little bit at a time. They find it very difficult to have a balanced total picture of the situation. This is what they need from us. What we should have in this country, which is a national mobilization, everybody against the enemy, the virus. You know, the way it is in a war. In a war, one is scared, but one all works very determinedly. This has not happened yet against AIDS. I think science can handle this situation, not overnight, because it is a new virus, a new disease, and we have to get our act together. We have started, though, and I think within 2 or 3 years we're going to have treatments, a variety of them, that are going to be effective, that can be used in combination, alternatingly, and so forth, and are really going to keep people alive and to prevent AIDS, which is the complicated stage of the infection. We're going to have people infected, but in good shape, in good health. We're also going to have a vaccine in the long run. But in the meantime, having this prospect and knowing that how the virus is transmitted exactly, you know, through sex, blood, and not casual contact, we can start preventing the transmission of the infection through public education and through people changing their behaviors. It takes a change in human behavior in order to stop the transmission of the virus. So the two things on the agenda immediately now are public education, intensive, general, nationwide, repeated, and frank and explicit, and pushing research as fast as we can. This virus and other viruses related to it, we know that, insert their genetic material in the genetic material of the cells they infect. And once it's there, it cannot be removed. We don't know how to do that. So we cannot, we think, speak of a cure, because there will always be, in following infection, presence of a piece of virus in the cells of the human body. But that is not enough to cause disease. The disease is caused by the virus multiplying, expressing itself, and killing certain cells. If we can prevent it from killing cells, it will not cause disease. So it doesn't matter if you can call it a cure or not, as long as people remain well. We know that there is a very long incubation period to this disease. People live for months and years with the infection without adverse effects. We hope that most of them will live long enough to be able to help them.